In the name of the living God, who is Creator, Christ, and Holy Spirit. Well, we're sort of halfway through Lent, the first Sunday of Lent. That's all we read today. And as you know, throughout the year, we have this journey throughout the year of liturgical and ministry observations of our and proclamations of our faith in Jesus Christ. And during these 40 days of Lent, it's really a journey to the wilderness, as simple as the image we have. Because at the time when we are encouraged to look honestly at ourselves, to take stock of where we are in that journey, to ask for forgiveness, to confess our sins, to ask for forgiveness, to repent. Basically, it's a time to make changes. We can do this any time during the year, but specifically during Lent, we're encouraged to identify and make changes in our spiritual journey that we think are important. I hope you have been doing that. And guess what? You've got some more time to work on this film. And it's important. It's important for us to know how things are going in our life with Christ. It's important to say, you know what, I think I could do this better. I think God could be better. I could be more open to God. It's important to open ourselves up to be transformed by the love of Jesus Christ throughout the year, but really during Lent. It's a time to think about that and to pray about that. Well, it just so happens the gospel for today is talking about that very thing. And this time when Jesus goes into the temple and cleanses it, it's a story that's in all four gospels. In John, the gospel according to John is a little bit different. It's written more about love. In the synoptic gospels, Matthew, Mark, and Luke, it's really more about justice. We're going to talk about love today. And that's why during this season of Lent, one of the opening sentences in penitential order is the one about love God, love your neighbor as yourself. And really sort of say, where are we with this thing about love God? Love God. And it takes time of transformation. That's that key word that applies to the Gospel of John, the story of Jesus, because his message basically is, folks, it's time for transformation. You're in the temple. It's a place of worship. It always was. It always would be. But animals were in there. The money changers were there so that people who came to make a sacrifice offering to God birds were able to have the right sign, the right coinage to do that. But the whole point is the image that Jesus is painting is, there's not any love going on here. There's not any real prayer going on here. So Jesus, in his anger, upsets everything and tells them to get out, to stop it. And instead, he asks them to focus on him. The temple's going to be rebuilt in 3 days. What do you mean 3 days? Well, he's talking about himself. So that's the message for us on this. Jesus, who is the primary one to reveal to us the truth of the God that we worship. Jesus, the one who said over and over again, acted in love, said, love your neighbor, love one another. Jesus, who set the example for our own behavior in that temple, was saying, look at me. Do what I do, and act like I act. Don't worry about the sacrifices. Don't worry about any of that stuff. Focus on me. He was asking those people in the temple, whether they're worshiping or not, be transformed, be changed, be converted. And again, that message is being sent to us through this very worship today. Well, the past 6 months, we've been in a little formation. We've been reading Marcus Ford, Brian Claren, Richard Rohr. And you know what? They've been talking about the same thing. That it really seems like now is the time for those of us Christians to look at the possibility of personal transformation in our journeys. And therefore, whether they need to get more honest and passionate about their faith in Jesus, and also corporate transformation, societal transformation. I mean, my point is this, is that it's something that's going on, and it's something that we are part of, and it's something that's speaking to us over and over again. And one of those ways that is speaking to you over and over again, me. Because I think it's important. And one of the ways, one of the practices, one of the activities that we can choose to do, again, I've said this before, but one of the practices that we can choose to do is to be very still and open to the presence of God. Call it centering prayer or listening prayer, whatever you want to call it. But I invite you again, I implore you, if you haven't already made the commitment, to commit 10 to 15 minutes a day to be still. There are lots of ways to do this. Basically, it's being still and quiet and listening for God. Feeling God's love. Releasing those other messages and busyness that are going on in your head. To be present. Just for 10 to 15 minutes. Quality presence with the God in whom we believe. And why do I keep saying that? I mean, why do I keep lifting that up? Why do I think that's more important? Because I think that's the primary, the first way that we can really be transformed. We can also be transformed by the way we live our lives. Lots of ways, but this, during our season of Lent, this is the time to be particularly spiritual about it. And we all can do it. There is a movement through our culture, maybe even through the world, that is the movement of the Spirit that's inviting us to go deeper. And it is something that we talk about in the St. James. We ask you, and see where God leads us as a parish community. See where God leads us as individuals. For the world is calling to people like us to stand up and speak to love and speak to justice and make a difference. May you this Lent feel that God of love in some new way. Let it come. See how it moves you to some sort of action with others, some sort of action for the common good of the communities in which we live. For God through Jesus.